What's going on, and thank you for joining me today. I'm Patty McStoner. On today's episode, we're going to be making a major upgrade to one of the tents that's going to be a big game changer as far as the garden goes. I'm really excited about this one here today, as this is an upgrade in the garden that I've been wanting to make for quite some time. Today we're going to be installing and reviewing the smart controlled 4-inch inline duct fan by Spider Farmer. Let's get it growing. And here we go. So let me show you how I'm gonna hook this thing all up on the outside of my tent. I'll take you through how the thing works and why I think it's gonna be a complete game changer for my grow. And then we'll check in after I've used it for a week and I'll tell you what I think about how it's performing. I'm going to be installing this fan on the shorter of my 3x3 tents, just beside it, right where I had the old carbon filter. I just start off by getting the carbon filter into place with the sock on. Then I put one of the ring clamps on over top of the top of the carbon filter. Next thing, I need the inline fan. I need to make sure that I have the arrow of the airflow pointing down into the carbon filter. If you were installing this all in the tent, you'd want the arrow pointing away from the carbon filter. Now you just take the inline fan and slide it in the top. Then you can tighten the clamp using a screwdriver to secure the carbon filter to the inline fan. Once that's done, we can move on to connecting the ducting to the inline fan. To start that off, you want to make sure you put a ring clamp over top to the ducting before you put it on the inline fan. Thinking back now in hindsight, doing this part, I probably would have laid this down and just installed it over top that way, because holding onto the clamp and the ducting at the same time and getting them to stay still was definitely a struggle, but we live and we learn. Again, we just use a screwdriver to secure the ducting to the top of the inline fan using the ring clamp. And we're on to installing it into the tent now. So we start out by measuring out the amount of ducting that we're gonna need and just cutting that using a utility blade. To cut through the metal wire, I just use a pair of metal shears. I like to fold the end of the duct in on itself just to make it all nice, and you could even tape it up all nice if you wanted to. Then we just slide the ducting into the tent in the duct hole that you want it in, and we tighten up the little drawstrings there. And that's it for getting the actual inline duct fan unit installed. Let's just take a quick look at how that looks up next to the nice little SP2000 I got in this 3x3 tent. And we're on to installing the control panel here. And that's really as easy as just picking a spot on the wall. I have a nice board here right beside the tent for it to go on, and just screwing it to the wall. From there, we can work on getting power to the inline fan. First, we connect the power cord to the inline fan on one end and then to the controller on the other end. And the last thing there is to do is just hook up the sensor. So you hang that in the tent where you want it to hang. Generally, you want it to be about canopy level, and then that just hooks into the controller on the other end. The best part of this smart inline duct fan by Spider Farmer is that it allows me to set the high and low humidity as well as temperature levels. Having that kind of control makes it so that the inline fan is only on when it needs to be and allows you to dial in the environment to exactly what it should be for the life stage that the plant is currently in. To set that all up, you basically just need to set your temperature and your humidity ranges in the alarm mode. And then what you do is you move over to the auto mode and choose the high humidity setting or high temperature setting, whichever one you want to go with, and the alarms will trigger it to go off at the low or the high settings that you set it to. So the difference that that's going to make for me is this: because where I grow is pretty dry, having the fan run all the time keeps the air dry all the time. So instead of having it be dry in the tent all the time, I'm going to be able to trap some of that humidity at night and exhaust it when it gets too humid in there. And I'm going to be able to hang on to that for as long as I can during the day, as well as when I get too hot in the tent, I'm going to be able to exhaust that air and get new, colder air from my room. And where there used to be absolutely no point in me even trying to control the environment because the fan was always running and exhausting that air, now I can start to try to dial it in and go for more the middle of that optimum range of where plants like to grow. I'm really happy with the tent setup that I have here. Now in this tent I have an SP2000 and this smart inline fan, both from Spider Farmer. I'm gonna be able to grow some gigantic plants. I've been using this thing for just over a week now, and I can't praise this thing enough. It has totally changed my mindset. Like I said, now that I can control the environment, I'm actually able to put some effort into doing that. And I wasn't able to do that before. Not to mention, this thing is way quieter than any of the other fans that I have. In fact, just the fan that's on the inside of the tent that I use to blow air around in there, it's louder than the inline fan when it turns on. And considering that this thing only ever comes on every so often, it's incredibly quiet because most of the time it's not even on. I love the black and orange color scheme on it. The parts and pieces are all made out of the right stuff. It's even got a metal mounting bracket on it, which is absolutely great if you want to mount it to the wall. This is the first one that I've seen anyways that has an actual metal bracket for mounting it to the wall. I can't wait to see how this thing works through an entire grow cycle. Now, is this something that somebody needs if they're just starting out? No, probably not. It really depends on what environmental needs you have where you're at. But as an upgrade item, as something to take growing to the next level, this is definitely great. I can say that it works well. And I think my only problem in the future is getting my hands on more of these so I can upgrade the rest of my tents. That's going to be it for today, everyone. Catch you on the next one.